TMac lap 2, 28.283 seconds.
Want to improve your flying and racing skills and track your progress? In today's video, we're going to show you how with a PIDFLIGHT lap timer. Stick around.
What is this thing? Let's crack it open and find out.
This orange cylindrical object is a key component to this device. It's very technical in nature. It's a cardboard tube which a poster came in that was shipped to me a long time ago, and I found it in my garage. That's the only reason I'm using it. What is special is the stuff inside this tube. PIDFLIGHT lap timer. We'll go over the components inside.
Okay, we're going to quickly go over the components here. We'll start with the brains of the operation, which is this Arduino chip, the RX5808 receiver, and this Wi-Fi module. We also have three resistors, these blue resistors. They're 1 kilo ohm resistors, and this is just an adapter cable that I hooked up to the pins coming out of the PCB. The printed circuit board for the PCB is a PIDFLIGHT LAP Rev 2, which I ordered from Seed Studio. Not necessary, but it just makes the build cleaner. To power this, I have a mini USB to USB cable attached to a step down 5 volt regulator. The whole PIDFLIGHT LAP timer is powered from 5 volts. But what I wanted to do was to be able to power it from any of my XT60 LiPo batteries, which obviously have more than 5 volts. So I just made this adapter from an XT60 to the 5 volt step down voltage regulator to the USB to mini USB connector straight to the Arduino chip. The main components, once again, are the Arduino chip, the RX5808 receiver module, and three 1,000 ohm resistors. This is a buzzer that is not required, and this is a Wi-Fi module. You can also use the lap timer with Bluetooth or direct connectivity. The instructions for all of this are going to be at a website which I will link below. It's PIDFLIGHT.com, developed by a gentleman by the name of Christian Mengler. So I'll put all the links in the description below that you will need to access the full schematic and instructions and whatnot on this PIDFLIGHT lap timer.
All right, what I'd like to do now is to go over the concept of the operation of the PIDFLIGHT lap timer. What we have here is a diagram depicting the received signal strength indicator value over time. We also have one PIDFLIGHT device. Although two are shown here, it's one device separated by time. The PIDFLIGHT lap timer operates from an application which there are two versions of. One's a free version, which has a limited number of laps that can be timed. I believe it's 3 at this particular point in time. And then there's a premium version, which expands upon that as well as other capabilities. On either of the versions, the user needs to input just a few variables. One of the variables would be the video transmitter frequency that the quadcopter is operating off of. The minimum time expected to complete a lap. So if you normally run the lap on that particular course in 20 seconds, you might want to put a minimum time of about 18 seconds in. The RSSI value, threshold value, which is depicted here by this dotted line, is actually calibrated automatically through the application on your mobile device. But it can be manually overridden by the user just by typing in a different value. What I normally do is if it's calibrated at a value of, say, 240, then I reduce that by about 20 and type in 220. And that way the PIDFLIGHT lap timer, I know, will be sensitive enough to pick up the VTX frequency as the quadcopter passes through the gate or the area in which the PIDFLIGHT device is. So we've got the frequency, we've got the RSSI threshold value calibrated or user-defined, the minimum time to complete a lap, and the number of laps in the race or practice. So if you're going to run, say, 7 laps, then you want to put in at least 7, you know, perhaps 10, and that way you're insured that the PIDFLIGHT lap timer will count all of the 7 laps that you expect to complete. The concept is pretty simple. As the quadcopter approaches the PIDFLIGHT device, the RSSI value is going to increase as it gets closer to the device. At some point, it's going to cross over the threshold value, and it's going to peak out. And then as the quadcopter departs from the PIDFLIGHT device along its path on the racetrack, the value of the RSSI is going to decrease, fall below the threshold value, and the quadcopter continues along the racetrack. At some point, the quadcopter is going to be approaching the PIDFLIGHT device again. The RSSI signal is therefore going to increase in value until it once again crosses the threshold, peaks out, and declines and goes below the threshold value again. So the concept is, as the quadcopter approaches the PIDFLIGHT device, the RSSI signal value gets increased, peaks out, and decreases. And what the PIDFLIGHT device does is it measures the amount of time between the two peaks of the RSSI value. That will be considered your lap time. All right, let's see how this simple concept is put into practice with a PIDFLIGHT application. After you've set up your mobile device with a PIDFLIGHT Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, then go ahead and plug in your LiPo, and in your mobile device settings, choose the PIDFLIGHT Wi-Fi and connect to it. Open the PIDFLIGHT app, click on the Wi-Fi icon in the upper right-hand corner, and the PIDFLIGHT app will say,
connected.
From there, your device screen will come up. Click on the device 1 text, and the screen will come up that shows pilot name, channel frequency, RSSI threshold, minimum lap time, and maximum lap time. You can go ahead and type in whatever pilot name you want. The default is pilot 1, but as you can see in the screenshot, I've renamed mine to TMac. Below that is where you input your channel frequency that your quadcopter is operating off of. Below that is your RSSI threshold. Now, what you want to do at this point is power on your, obviously, your transmitter and your quad. You want to place your quad on the opposite side of the gate from the PIDFLIGHT device, and then just push calibrate. The application will automatically calibrate the RSSI threshold for you. Now, once again, what I normally do is I take that value and then I subtract 10 or 20 from it manually type that value into the RSSI threshold. You also want to put the minimum lap time in. So if you're running, normally run 20 second laps, then I would suggest putting in a number less than that so that it actually captures the lap, and just in case you happen to be flying great that day. And also the maximum number of laps, which we've gone over. Once you're done inputting the various parameters into this device screen, click on Save. From there, click on the circular arrow to reset your lap timing, and a screen will pop up that says reset lap timing, yes or no. You want to click yes, and what that does is it clears out all previous laps from your previous races, and then at that point you are ready to race. You're ready to start flying or practice, and you click on the stopwatch icon at the upper part of the screen.
Less than 5, 4, 3 2, 1.
And you're ready to go. Once you've started flying and are up in the air, then you just listen to your lap times throughout your flight and attempt to better your lap times on each lap, which is what this is all about.
TMac, lap 1, 33.58 seconds. TMac, lap 2, 32.698 seconds. TMac, lap 3, 29.94 seconds. TMac, lap 4, 30.717 seconds.
And then when you're done with your laps, you can click on the lap tab and view each of your individual laps. And then you can also click on the race tab, view a summary of your laps to include your last lap, your fastest lap, and your total time for all laps
together. Well, that's it. It's as simple as that. Not bad for about $15 to build and a few dollars per year. That's a very small price to pay for improving and tracking your progress on your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing. I wanted to personally thank our fellow FPV brother, Christian Mengler, for coming up with and implementing this whole idea, and for making a tool such as PIDFLIGHT affordable and accessible to most FPV pilots everywhere. Now for the special announcement. We're going to do a giveaway. For this particular giveaway, if you're interested, we'll be giving away one of these PIDFLIGHT Rev 2 circuit boards to one lucky winner. Now let's make that two lucky winners. And also we'll throw in a few resistors to go along with it. The rules are simple. You have to be a subscriber. If you're not a subscriber now, click on the subscribe button below. For this particular contest, you need to make sure that your subscriptions are made public, are publicly available for view so that I can verify that you are a subscriber. Secondly, got to click on the like button, the thumbs up button below. Smash it. And lastly, you need to make one and only one comment in the comment sections below. We'll use a random comment picker on the 24th of August to pick our two lucky winners for the printed circuit board and the few resistors to go along with it. My hope is that you will use those to build your own PIDFLIGHT lap timer and improve and track your FPV flying progress. If you like this video, click on the thumbs up button below. Share it with your family, friends, and coworkers. Make sure to subscribe to your channel for our journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. And if you want to get notified of when future videos are posted, ring that bell below. I'm TMac. We'll see you in the next video. Happy flying!